Welcome to this pin explanation session of 8051 microcontroller. So here my goal will be to explain you the pins of the microcontroller and their functionalities. So I'll go from pin number 1 to pin number 40 because this is a 40 pin microcontroller. Now the first pin is labeled as P1.0. This means that this is the 0th pin of port 1. This terminology is because we have 4 ports in 8051 microcontroller. These ports are namely P0, P1, P2 and P3, that is port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3. So this is the first port of the 8051 microcontroller. Now here, P1.0 to P1.7, these are all general I/O pins. That means they can be used only for general purpose input and output from the 8051 microcontroller. This means that we can either input a bit or output a bit through each of the pins. And this is done through the port 0 register of the 8051 microcontroller. For example, if we want to input a bit 1 on the P1.0 and rest all of the pins should be 0, so we can do it by setting this pin as high and the rest of pins as grounded. So when this is done, the P0 register will read a value as 0x01, that is only one bit high at the pin number 1. Similarly, if we want to write a bit byte on the port 0, we can write it by writing it on the P0 register. In a language like C, we can do this by just assigning it the value 0x01, that is a hex value for the binary 00000001. So in this way, we can set a pin high through the program in the 8051 microcontroller. So this is how the general purpose I/O pins work. Now this is this port 1 can only be used as general purpose I/O, while there are many other pins who can be used as general purpose I/O as well as their multiple functionalities are there. So we will go through them. First, now let us go serially to pin number 9 now. Now pin number 9 is a reset pin. As the name says, it resets the microcontroller whenever a high pulse is detected. When we set this pin as high, the microcontroller simply starts the program from the start again. Now let us move on to the serial communication. Now the pin number 10 and 11 are labeled as RxD and TxD. They are respectively receive serial bit and transmit serial bit pins. These are used for serial communication with any other outside terminal like the PC terminal or any other, so that data can be communicated between the 8051 microcontroller and the external system. Now let us move on to the other pins, that is interrupt. Pin number 12 and pin number 13 are INT0 and INT1, that is interrupt pins. Now these are labeled as INT0 bar and INT1 bar. This means that these are active low pins. So whenever a low pulse is given, the interrupt is generated. Similarly, on the INT1, when a low pulse is given, an interrupt is generated. The interrupt can be low, or it can be even edge driven depending upon how the internal registers are configured. Now the function of the interrupt is such that when a low pulse, for example, when it generates an interrupt, so my 8051, whatever it is doing at that time, it halts doing that and simply services this interrupt. So if we want an external event to be recorded and a reaction to be given on that event. So we can do it by this, that it gives a low pulse on the INT 0 pin, and we can display something with the help of our ISR routine, that is interrupt service routine, and then the 8051 goes back again to its normal functioning. Similar is the functioning of the INT1 interrupt. Now let us move to pin number 14, that is T0, and pin number 15, that is T1. Now T0 and T1 are both inputs to the counters of related to timer 0 and timer 1. Counters, as the name indicates, they are used to count pulses. Whenever external events occur and we want to count the number of times they have occurred, we can do this by just putting the pulse, that is coming through the external event to these pins, that is T0 or T1, and we can record the number of events that are occurring. Now let us move on to pin number 16 and pin number 17, that is read bar and write bar. WR bar and RD bar are active low signals which are used to read and write respectively on external memories. So this was the port 3 from pin number 10 to pin number 17. So what we saw is port 3 can be used as these functionalities that I have explained, and also they can be used as general purpose IO depending upon how we want to use it. We configure it in our program. Now let us move on to pin number 18 and 19. Pin number 18 and 19 are XTEL2 and XTEL1. That is, they are for the purpose of connecting external crystal circuitry to them. External crystal circuitry actually gives them the clock pulses that it needs to execute. For example, we can connect a 12 MHz oscillator to a crystal oscillator to across it, which will help the 8051 microcontroller to generate 12 clock cycles in 1 microsecond. So XTEL2 and XTEL1 are used for external crystal circuitry to be connected to the 8051 microcontroller. Now pin number 20 is the ground pin, that is used to complete the circuit from 5 volt supply to ground. That means this is connected to the ground of the power supply. Let us move on to pin number 21, which starts as P2.0, and also it is labeled as A8. That means this is the 0th pin of port 2, as well as this is the A8 bit of the address. Now I'll tell you what this address means. If you see here, it's going from A8 to A9 to till A15 it's going. This simply means that it is the higher byte of the address that it will be using for communication of address to the external peripheral that will be connected to it whenever external memories are connected to the 8051 microcontroller. So this feature is used when external memory is connected to the microcontroller, and this is the port that gives a higher byte address of the memory that is to be addressed. Also, apart from being used as the address lines, these can be used as GPIO, that is general purpose input output pins. So same goes to story for P2.0 through P2.7, that is the entire port 2. Now pin number 29 is PSEN, that is program store enable. This is an active low input. Now we will move on to pin number 30, that is ALE or bar prog. ALE is simply address latch enable. That means whenever this pin is high, it tells the program that the port 2 will be carrying address, and port 0, which I will be telling now, will be carrying address also, which will be also carrying address, and it will be the lower byte address in this case, as the port 2 was having the higher byte address. Similarly, now here port 0 is having the lower byte address of the external device being addressed. So pin number 30 is used for that purpose. Pin number 31 is EA bar. It is actually used for accessing program from external memory. So this is actually the feature used mostly in 8031 and other such microcontrollers who don't have internal ROM. EA bar, when being grounded, it tells the microcontroller that the program is not internal but in some external ROM, and the program is read from them. When it is held high, EA bar, it tells us 8051 that the program is internal ROM and not in an external ROM. So this was the function of EA bar. EA bar should always be high whenever we are using microcontrollers who have internal ROM to store the program in them. Now let us move on to pin number 32. Pin number 32 is the 8th pin of port 0, it is P0.7. It is also labeled as AD7. As I previously told, it is actually the address line bit, and it stores this 8th bit of the lower byte of the address of the external memory being addressed. Similarly, the same story goes for the entire port 0. Port 0.0 through port 0.7 holds the lower byte address whenever ALE is high, and whenever ALE is low, it stores our normal data. That means it can be used as general purpose for IO. Now we come to our last pin, that is pin number 40, which is the VCC. That means the 5 volt power supply should be given to here. The most important ones here were the pin number 40, which is the VCC supply, the pin number 20, which is the ground, pin number 18, 19, which are XTALs for crystal circuitry. These are, and also the pin number 31 that tells the internal program is there in the ROM. So these are main because these are actually who decide that the microcontroller is functioning or not. The rest of them function if these are properly connected. So this was the explanation for the pins of the 8051 microcontroller. Thank you.